What's going on, guys? What's going on? This is Zeke, Documentary TV. Oh, man, it's a great day out here in Southern California. Hopefully you guys are, wherever you guys are having a wonderful day as well. The weather's wonderful. I did see an alert that was this. I guess that was Europe, maybe. There's bad weather in Europe right now. All right. Kaboom 362 is in the house. Sean 313 is in the house. I'm a little tired today. Let me jazz it up a little bit. I don't know what's going on with me, man. Let me jazz it up a little bit. I had a good night's sleep, so I should have energy. I'm approaching this show a little differently. Did a little bit more research. Hopefully the show has a little bit more structure to it today. But today we'll be talking about the Belgian Malinois and the German Shepherd, two breeds that are often mistaken for one another. They also are two breeds that are very similar in the work that they do. So I think it's going to be a good discussion, a good conversation. I'm going to pretty much give you guys, obviously I'm going to do like we always do, trying to build a format here. I'm going to show you guys a couple of videos that I've done on the breeds. We can talk about those videos. We can talk about those dogs, the dogs themselves. I'm going to kind of break down my thoughts about the breeds, each of them. Go over some different talking points or different issues on each breed. And then I'm going to reach out for you guys in the comment section and try to get some of your feedback and get some of your thoughts on the breeds. All right, guys, like always, please, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Like the video if you like this kind of content. If you want to make sure that your comment is seen by me, it's always great to super chat. It doesn't matter the amount. It doesn't have to be a lot at all. But it just is that based on the way the system is set up, when you super chat, it highlights it, freezes it, and I'm sure, you know, it's a 99% chance that I'll see it. But much better chance than if you just comment, because when the room gets busy, comments just go right by the screen. I don't see them all. But like I said, we're going to be talking about the German Shepherd and the Belgian Malinois. And I am going to shout out Christian, who just got into the room as well. What's up, my brother? Let's go ahead. Let's start with the videos. We're going to start with the, let's see which video we're going to start. I think we're going to start with the German Shepherd video. So let's do that first.
Documentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Oh, no, we're not. That was yesterday's show. Give me 1 second, guys. There we go.
Documentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
If you're looking for a loyal and intelligent companion, then a German Shepherd is an excellent choice. These dogs are intelligent, highly trainable, and agile, making them great partners for activities such as jogging, agility competitions, or tracking. German Shepherds are incredibly loyal and will protect their family with devotion. So if you're in need of a guard dog, these canines make great options. The German Shepherd is one of the most iconic and beloved dog breeds in the world. A part of the herding group, German Shepherds have been guarding and protecting humans for centuries. The breed's origin can be traced back to 19th century Germany, where it was developed by Captain Max von Steffenitz. At that time, von Steffenitz saw potential for a highly intelligent and loyal breed that would excel as both working dogs and family companions. The original goal was to create a collaborative animal that could assist on farms and with herding sheep, as well as serve as guard dogs. German Shepherds became well known in World War I when they served alongside military personnel in various capacities, such as carrying messages between battalions and providing medical aid to injured soldiers. The fame of this courageous breed increased even more after Ren 10-10, a rescued German Shepherd pup from France, gained celebrity status by appearing in several hit films throughout the 1920s and 1930s. Today, German Shepherds are highly valued worldwide for their intelligence, trainability, loyalty, and courage, making them sought after candidates for police work, search and rescue missions, military service roles, and assistance to disabled individuals. In addition to being used as working dogs or guard dogs, they remain popular family pets due to their calm demeanor around children. When looking for a good puppy, it's important to research the breed and their desired characteristics. German Shepherds are loyal, intelligent, and agile, but they also require specific training needs in order to be at their best. It's important to find a breeder who is experienced with the breed and can provide information about the health of the puppy's parents. Ask for proof of health tests such as hip dysplasia or elbow dysplasia screenings, as well as any necessary vaccinations that have been given prior to purchase. When meeting with potential breeders, ask questions about their practices, such as how often they socialize puppies before they are sold and if they have experience training them. It's also important to recognize that German Shepherds require lots of daily exercise. They're an active breed with high energy levels and will need regular walks or runs each day. Without proper mental stimulation, these dogs can become bored quickly, so having access to a fenced in yard or safe outdoor access is essential for their well-being. German Shepherds are highly intelligent and loyal dogs that require proper training and socialization to reach their full potential. Training and socialization is essential for German Shepherds, as it teaches them how to appropriately interact with humans and other animals, as well as establishes boundaries and expectations. Without proper training, a German Shepherd may become aggressive or destructive due to boredom or lack of direction. The breed's intelligence can easily be harnessed to excel in obedience classes, agility training, tracking, or advanced canine sports such as shutsun. Training these activities encourages mental stimulation and can help prevent problem behaviors from forming. Additionally, early socialization is very important for these dogs. It's best to start exposing them to different situations, people, and animals when they're young so they can learn how to confidently approach new situations without fear or aggression. When it comes to training, positive reinforcement methods are the most effective method for teaching your German Shepherd new skills with minimal stress on both you and the dog. Positive reinforcement involves using rewards such as treats or verbal praise when your pup learns a desired behavior. This encourages him or to repeat that behavior in the future. Consistency is key when teaching German Shepherds. Use the same commands each time you request a certain behavior from your pup so they become comfortable with following through on those requests. Overall, proper training and socialization are very important for German Shepherds since they possess an eagerness to please their owners, but need guidance on how best to do that effectively. Early exposure will help ensure that your pup grows into a confident adult dog who will bring joy into your home for years to come. Finally, you should visit the puppies in person before making a decision on which one to take home. Don't just rely on photographs. Try to observe their behavior and personality traits so you can get an idea of what type of pup would be best suited for your lifestyle and family dynamics. Take your time when selecting the right pup. It will be worth it in the end. If you're interested in the best dog breed documentaries, subscribe to Dogumentary TV. All right, there you go, guys. So that's the German Shepherd. A great breed. A breed that, you know, has a history and a history of, in terms of work, a wide variety of work. It does everything from herding, police work, military work. Obviously, these dogs can be therapy dogs. I believe they do tracking as well. So it's a dog breed that, I mean, as a pet, they're great for sure. They're great. They're great pets. They're amazing working dogs. Let's jump into the next video. Let's do the Belgian Malinois. Let me make sure I get the right video for you guys. This is not it.
Dogumentary. Go. Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Appreciate you. Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In this video, I'll be doing a breed review of the Belgian Malinois. Let's first get into some facts about the breed. The Belgian Malinois is a breed that will live a long time. It has a life expectancy of 12 to 14 years. In regards to the breed's temperament, it is known to be stubborn, alert, hardworking, active, friendly, confident, protective, and watchful. The breed is considered to be a medium to large sized dog. Males weigh between 55 and 66 pounds. Females are 49 to 55 pounds. In regards to height, females are 22 to 24 inches. Males are 24 to 26 inches. Historically speaking, the Belgian Malinois is a sheepdog and was originally used for herding. Malinois are a variety of the Belgian Shepherd dog, which comes in four different varieties. Malinois are identifiable from the other breeds by their short coat. Breed also comes in the colors of fawn, mahogany, and black. Today, the Malinois used much less on the farm and much more so in military and police applications. Around the world, the Malinois is considered to be the elite dog breed when it comes to police and military work. If you're interested in bringing a Malinois into your pet home, there are a lot of things that I personally would take into consideration. First and foremost, Malinois today are really bred to be workers. Much of the breeding stock out there is for, like I said earlier, is used in police and military applications. These dogs can live in pet homes, but they require a lot of work. So some of the things that I would take into consideration before buying or considering a Malinois as a pet is, first and foremost, how much time do I have to provide to this dog in terms of physical and mental stimulation? This breed has a tremendous amount of drive and very high level of intelligence. Without the proper amount of stimulation, these dogs can become very destructive. Okay, so once you've reconciled the fact that you do have the time to own a Belgian Malinois, the next thing you want to take into consideration is, well, what exactly would you do? One of the great things about this breed is that they have a tremendous amount of energy and they're down to do almost anything that makes you happy. These dogs are runners, so if you're a trail runner, a Belgian Malinois is a great running partner. The breed does very well in protection work, police work, search and rescue, tracking, agility. With any of these activities though, my suggestion would be to make sure that you take it up a notch, meaning that the courses should provide the dog not only with physical obstacles, but maybe even mental obstacles. This is a very intelligent dog breed. They need to be mentally stimulated as well as physically stimulated. Now, I feel like I say this in all of my breed review videos, but there is a big difference between working and pet quality dogs, or show dogs, I guess I would say. That difference could be no more distinct than with the Belgian Malinois. Working Belgian Malinois, first of all, every Belgian Malinois is going to be extremely energized. You know, just think of your most energetic dog with an extra boost of energy. That's what Belgian Malinois typically are. Now, if you're talking about a working Belgian Malinois, you may want to times that times 10. The level of focus, energy, and drive in a working Belgian Malinois is second to none. That is why, specifically, these dogs are used so much in military and police work. So my suggestion is, if you're going to look for a Belgian Malinois for a pet home, please go to a show breeder or someone who is specifically breeding Belgian Malinois for pet homes as companions. I'm not sure that you can find that, but if you can, that's what you want. I've done a video with a young lady who brought a working Malinois into her home. She made it work, but it was a lot of work. All right, guys, so I'm not one who recommends Belgian Malinois for pet homes, and I also do not recommend the breed for first-time dog owners. Not because the dog is dangerous or reckless in any way, but because this dog is so serious that any owner who is not as serious and focused and capable as a Belgian Malinois will probably run into a tremendous amount of problems. And like I said before, this breed can be destructive if not properly stimulated. All right, guys, so listen, if you guys are looking to get a Belgian Malinois and you have a working purpose for the breed, I encourage you to do your research, find a breeder who can provide you with the best dog for yourself and your family. All right, I'll talk to you guys on the next one. Peace. All right, there you go, guys. That is the Belgian Malinois. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. If you would like to support this channel, you can hit the like button. You can actually join the channel, channel's membership. And you can also go watch all the videos in my catalog. We got about 1,000. Yeah, hit that like button. Thank you, Sean. Guys, so there you have the two breeds, the German Shepherd, the Belgian Malinois. First, I want to talk briefly about the history of both breeds. Let's just go back, obviously. The German Shepherd is from Germany. The Belgian Malinois is from Belgium. And both breeds were herders, or are herders, that were, because of their intelligence and physical capabilities, make excellent police dogs. I believe the German Shepherd probably started doing police work maybe a decade or two before they introduced the Belgian Malinois to police work. I don't know why. Probably just the circumstances of the countries that the breeds were developed in. But both dogs are excellent police dogs. Today, it appears that the Belgian Malinois is the breed of choice for police work and military work. And I say that only because I see far more Belgian Malinois now, doing that type of work. I know I talked to a police canine officer several years ago, and he did say that, you know, aside from the dog's keen intelligence and focus, they're also smaller, and that's also a benefit. You know, they're smaller with the same amount of power and impact in dealing with criminals. So the Belgian Malinois for police work is the go-to breed, which is great. But for me and for most of us watching this video, we are going to be either pet owners, recreational sport. What do you call those guys? Well, you know, your dog sports, protection work. That's recreation. That's not a professional thing. There may be some professionals watching. What's up, professionals? But for most of us, we're looking for a companion. And in that case, you know, my pick, my choice would be the German Shepherd. I think the German Shepherd is makes for a better companion. It's a little less fire in it than the a little less energy. I don't want to say fire because I think I used the way I used fire yesterday. I don't want to attribute fire to these two breeds. Let's just say energy. In terms of physical characteristics, like I was saying earlier, the German Shepherd is a little bit bigger. But the breeds do exist on the spectrum, like all breeds do. You can find a small German Shepherd the same size as roughly the same size as a Belgian Malinois, and you would definitely get the pros of a German Shepherd, less energy and all that stuff, and the benefits of having a smaller dog. So you can find a smaller German Shepherds, but you're going to have to work with your breeder and, you know, hope that they give you, that they're honest with you in assessing, you know, the puppy. Because some puppies can start out small, but if they know their dogs get big, they're going to get big anyway, even if it is a small puppy. I'm going to get to you guys' comments in a second. Let me just keep going through my list. So temperament and personality, that's a big thing for me. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the temperament or personality of a Belgian Malinois in isolation. For me as a person, it's just too much. I would prefer the German Shepherd over the Belgian Malinois. And like I said, again, we always got to understand, we're always talking about from my worldview, my perspective, what would I want to deal with, you know, 24/7? Because when you have a dog, it's a 24/7 situation. And I just think, you know, from being around them, Belgian Malinois are just, they're all over the place. You know, I'm a guy that likes to come home after working and just watch TV, maybe go for a walk, and I could toss the ball around, you know, but Belgian Malinois, they're going to need intense activity, mental and physical. So while the temperament personalities aren't that much different in the sense of the spectrum, again, like, and what I mean by different is that they can't overlap. You can find a very intense German Shepherd, but by rule, the German Shepherd breed is going to be a little less intense than the than Belgian Malinois. And that's a great thing, I think, you know, for family environments. Trainability, both of these dogs are very trainable. Both of these breeds are very trainable. They're known, their calling card is their trainability. That's why they are used for such detailed work as, you know, police and military work. And, you know, most herding breeds are highly intelligent. They're good problem solvers. They figure things out. So, you know, in terms of trainability, work ethics, you know, the ability to work, the workability, you could go with either breed in that sense. Exercise and activity needs. I think, again, they're both going to need exercise. They're both going to be required a commitment. I just think that the Belgian Malinois may require a bit more. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. I'm going to get to you guys in a second. The one thing I do want to talk about briefly about the German Shepherd, the biggest knock on him, and this is not something that you have to deal with, because there's other people out there breeding away from this. But it's, you know, a lot of times if you go to the AKC shows and you look at the rear assembly on the, you know, what's popular right now within these show rings, that slope rear, oh man, it's kind of painful to watch. But there are a lot of people, I've seen a lot of German Shepherds that are bred away from that. So you don't have to get that. So, and then when I'm talking about, just for the record, I'm talking about, I don't know if it's Western German or something, but there's a name, there's a way that they categorize these working German Shepherds. I guess you just call them working German Shepherds, who have the more functional rear. They don't have that exaggerated sloping rear. Those are the German Shepherds that I would recommend to anybody, whether you're looking for a pet or working. Definitely if you're looking for a working dog, that's what I would recommend. All right, guys, let me get into your comments. Let's see how far we're only 21 minutes into this. All right, that's good. All right, let's talk about it. I want to first and foremost say thank you to Best Pit Bull Breeder. That's Chico Lopez for the super chat. I appreciate that, man. Sean, I cannot pronounce your last name, brother. Piscitelli. My brother, I'm sorry. He says, I'm a law enforcement officer in a large agency, and you are correct, many miles. But definitely also German Shepherds and Dutch Shepherds. Yes, Dutch Shepherds, to me, you know, I think Dutch Shepherds and Belgian Malinois are really interchangeable. I think you would have to be someone like a canine officer or someone that's really deep into sports protection work to really understand the nuances of how these dogs differ. But just me as an observer, they're the same dog. Sal Savala says, ain't nothing like a Maligator. Got to have a few dogs under you to be able to handle their character. Yeah, definitely. I think both of these breeds, the German Shepherd and the Belgian Malinois are probably not for first-time owners. I would say that you could have less experience with dogs and deal with a German Shepherd, but you should have some experience with dogs. In terms of dealing with a Belgian Malinois, you should be very experienced if you're going to get that breed. Minister Anthony Jr. says he trusts German Shepherds more. Miles are known to misfire for sure. I will admit that, yes, I've never seen this happen, so I don't speak on it as if I know. But I will admit that I have heard stories of Belgian Malinois misfiring. I don't know what he means by misfiring, but I'm assuming you mean he bites the wrong person or whatever. I've seen that happen. I haven't seen that happen. I've heard of that happening. As a matter of fact, just the other day, I don't know, I was watching something on the internet, and a police officer, a canine officer, released a Belgian Malinois onto a suspect, and the dog attacked the officers around the suspect. But I don't think that's indicative of the breed, so I don't speak on it as if it's a trait of the breed. But there have been misfires, and I'm sure there's been German Shepherds that all breeds probably misfire. I mean, you can't, you know, mishaps happen, you know what I'm saying? I mean, people shoot the wrong people. You know what I mean? Officers shoot each other from time to time. So that stuff kind of happens. Sean says, also, Shepherd and Mile mixes, those are badass, the size of a Shepherd and the look of a Mile. I personally haven't really seen any, I haven't had any experience with the mixing of those two breeds. I would be interested. I mean, especially if someone has a solid working program where they're mixing Belgian Malinois and German Shepherds, I think that would be interesting. You know, until I see the results, I don't claim it to be good or bad. I just think that would be interesting. I'd like to see what comes of that. I would like to see that. Teeny Evans says, Miles are too crazy. Some people love it, but isn't for me. GSD are level-headed and can think a good working line. GSD is a gold, is golden. And I would agree in general with that assessment. That's kind of my assessment as well. I like to be nice. I have a channel, I talk to a lot of dog people, so I don't like to demean or dismiss a breed by calling it crazy. So I wouldn't call Belgian Malinois crazy. They are hyper for sure. Some of them can be really hyper. I think my assessment as well is that the German Shepherds are a much more level-headed dog, much more easier to live with. And if you can find one that goes on that spectrum, again, I love to talk about this more this way to the higher end, you'll get you a great dog. I got a super chat from Doug. Thank you, Doug. I haven't gotten down there yet. I'm scrolling down my chat list. When you send me a super chat, it tells me right on the screen. Doug just sent you a super chat. So thank you, Doug. I'll get down to your comment in a second. But I want to say thank you for that. Doc Trey's, a lot of those show lines have that slope rears. Yeah, the slope rear is not a great thing. I'm not with that. Bullies and Bibles, what's up? Let me read this. This I haven't gotten through the whole comment, but it sounds like it's going to be interesting. Giovanni Lewis says, the difference between a German Shepherd and a Belgian, throw a tennis ball off a cliff, German Shepherd will stop and try to figure out how to get the ball. The Belgian will jump off the cliff to get it. I like that. I'm not saying it's true. I think Belgian Malinois are smart enough not to do that, but I guess that's a metaphor. I don't know what that is. Well, I get your point. I think it's appropriate. I like that. Best pit bull breeder. Do you guys use treadmills on your dogs in the USA? A treadmill can help. Zeke, I respect the dedication to dog. Thank you, sir. I definitely feel like if I owned a Belgian Malinois, I would definitely invest in a treadmill. And there are people I know most of the people who I interview who are serious about working their dogs, most of them have a treadmill, a dog runner somewhere tucked in the corner, whether it's in the garage, a back room or something. So a lot of folks out here are using treadmills. More people probably should use them than because I think, again, it's a good way, especially with a high-energy breed like the Belgian Malinois, to get through the day but keeping your dog working. Belgian Malinois prey drive, that's Giovanni Lewis again, is really high. Thank you, Alejandro. Miles definitely have a lot of pent-up energy. Sean313, should owners learn to train dogs before getting these dogs? Sean313, I would suggest yes. Should you learn to train? Like, you should be aware of the training techniques. You should have some level of experience with dogs before getting either one of these breeds, in my opinion. And, I'm saying, should you learn to train? Yes. Should you be an expert? You don't have to be. And you probably, even if you know how to train, you should still work with a professional trainer. Because a lot, with these dogs, especially like with the Malinois, visual cues, audible cues that professionals will identify and know how to redirect and move the dog in a different direction or in the correct direction that you, who someone's just learned how to train dogs, you won't get. So even if you learn what you should learn, you should definitely learn and you should get better and better and better. Maybe after, 8 or 9 years of owning a Malinois, maybe you will be qualified to call yourself a dog trainer. Part of owning such a serious breed is taking it serious. And that means, doing your research. Not only should you know how to train dogs, you should understand dog physiology, dog psychology, sociology. You know, understand how does your dog interacting with it, because it becomes important. One of them, I own a Rottweiler, and one of the things that I use a lot with my dog, especially when we're out in public, is the visual cues from other dogs. My dog is still intact. So I have to understand, I have to look at other dogs and see how are they reacting to my dog? Because most dogs don't meet dogs that smell like my dog. Because, you know, obviously we don't have a bunch of intact dogs running around here. I chose to keep my dog intact. And for that reason, when I take him out in public, I have to be aware of things. So owning a breed like the Belgian Malinois, yeah, you want to be a dog trainer. You want to be a dog dietitian, because obviously what you're feeding this dog is going to want to be reflected in his activity level, his temperament. You know, if the dog is up, you know, when you have these dogs that are, what would you call them? Assertive. Breeds that are certain. There are a lot of assertive breeds, and that's just not just the Belgian Malinois. But when you deal with these confident, assertive breeds, you want them to be, you know, you don't want them to be having a bad day because you fed them something horrible or you got their diet messed up. So even being a good dietitian, canine dietitian, is something that you should take into account and maybe think about getting some information on. Let's move forward. All right, there we go. Doug, thank you, brother. Appreciate the super chat. A slap mill, yeah. That's just a treadmill. That's Doug talking about he's about to get himself a Dutch. Haas Degado. I don't know. I mean, listen, Google it. Like, if you want to find a wood treadmill, they're out there. I know people are making them, they're building them. You just have to Google it, find it. I'm sure someone will sell you one. Giovanni Lewis says, I train production jars. German Shepherds tend to go around things to get the bite, like a table. Belgians tend to want to jump over the table to get the bite. Belgian are also more athletic. Yeah, they're definitely, as a general rule, I would say they're definitely more athletic. And like I said, they're definitely more, they have a much higher prey drive. They're straight to the point. They like to get where they're going, Anwath, what's going on with you, brother? Cornelius. We had a Belgian Malinois, great dog, just a lot more than Akita's we had as well. I don't know what you're saying, Cornelius, but that's the last comment. But yeah, man, so that's it. And I already told you guys that, you know, for me personally, and I'm not saying that either breed is better than either. I mean, again, it's always situational with me. It's always understanding, like, what am I doing? And what am I going to need the dog to do when I'm picking the breed that I'm going to get for myself? So I think both of these dogs are great. I think, again, for me personally, I would probably go with the German Shepherd just based on my lifestyle. But if I were doing police work and I was in a tough situation dealing with tough criminals, aggressive people, I think that I would choose the Belgian Malinois, because I just think it's a dog that's a lot more serious, a lot more focused, has a lot more energy. Wouldn't say it's any more fearless, though. Like, that's the thing about it. Like, I wouldn't mistake the German Shepherd's propensity for going around objects as it being a little bit more cautious or fearful. It's just a different thought process in the breed, I think. But I do think that Malinois get to business quicker. They, like you said, they're gonna, instead of running around that table, they're gonna jump over it. You know, that chair's in the way, they're gonna jump over it. That door's in the way, they're gonna crash through it. That window, you know. And that's the thing about, I actually have a shot. I wish I'd have played that video. I actually have a shot a Belgian Malinois jumping into the car window of a moving car. The car wasn't moving that fast, but it was moving. And the level of athleticism, hand-paw coordination that the dog displayed was very impressive. You guys give me some more comments. Let's get back to your comments. It says Boston, Massachusetts, 617. I grew up with German Shepherds and a Rott. He was the most self-confident dog I ever saw. Never started any trouble, but was about business when necessary. Miles are neurotic. It's built in. May not be a trait most owners are used to. Yeah, I would agree with that. Nick M, again, I don't like to recommend, I don't mind recommending dog breeds per se. So, but again, like, you know, I really like to know the person before I tell them what kind of dog they should get. But there are a lot of great low energy dogs out there. I mean, you can start with the lowest of energy is the English Bulldog. Depending on your comfortability in terms of how much you're moving, you can move up to a French Bulldog. What else is very low energy? You go to bigger dogs like your if you want a big dog, Newfoundlands, your St. Bernard. There's so many dog breeds out there. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's crazy. It'd be better if I knew who you were and I could tell you what I thought fit in your lifestyle in your house. Giovanni Lewis, Belgian Malinois get bored real easily. They can destroy your yard. That's true. Like I said, Belgian Malinois need a tremendous amount of mental stimulation. I mean, you got to be prepared not only to, like, walk them, but, I mean, I'm talking, like, maybe take them. You got to take, if you're going to walk with them, it's got to be an adventure. You know what I'm saying? Like, it would be nice if you could run a trail with them, or if you're riding a bike and you can go through the mountains and they can hear things, notice things, jump over things, you know, run through creeks and just, you know, they're very, you know, intense dogs. Tini Evans, I don't know Shield Canine. If you want to send me a link, send me some information, you can send DM it to me in Instagram. I can check it out there. All right, guys. And that's Giovanni Lewis says, my Belgian Malinois work a lot, but they get bored very fast. They love to work and love to work. So that's pretty much it, guys. I think we've kind of all, like, even from my assessment and it seems like the community's assessment, that the both dogs are very capable at working, doing the work of police, protection work, herding, and that the German Shepherd is probably a little bit more suitable for family companionship. I did want to say one thing about the Belgian Malinois. I noticed a lot, like just this past month, I see a lot of people with Belgian Malinois, and they all appear to be about the same age. So I feel like that movie Dog that came out about a year or two really encouraged people to go out and get Belgian Malinois. So I'm going to want to probably try to find some folks out there, some families who are living with Belgian Malinois, and do a documentary on their experience with the breed. Like, because the one lady who I did interview, I did a living with Belgian Malinois. I'm sure many of you saw that. She was having a hard time with the breed. She had to change her life around considerably. She had to make a lot of concessions for the dog. If you went to her house looked, the whole house looked like a playpen for the Belgian Malinois. She had toys, treats, puzzles, maps all over the house just to kind of keep the dog occupied. And that's kind of what I'm saying about the breed, is that it is a very intense breed and something that's going to require a lot of your care and consideration. And I don't think it's that serious with the German Shepherd, definitely not with show line German Shepherds. But there are enough people out there breeding German Shepherds where I'm sure you can find you someone breeding family companion style German Shepherds. Let's see. We got a couple more questions. We got Haas Delgado. My AM staff that I had since a puppy has turned 11 and is still active. I thought she'd be less active as she got older. Is that normal? Well, I'll be very honest with you. I got a dog that's 16 years old, and he just slowed down about 2 years ago. And I'm not going to say he slowed down. He definitely slowed down. She should have slowed down by 11. She shouldn't be she shouldn't have the energy she had as a 1 or 2 year old dog. But she will still be active as an Amstaff at 11 than a lot of other breeds would be at like 5 or 6. They're just a very energetic breed. So I don't know how active she is, but I don't think that you're probably dealing with something that's out of the norm for an Amstaff. They're going to be active. Like I said, I got a pit mix. He was just as active as my puppy Rottweiler. When I got my puppy Rottweiler, my pit mix was 12 or 11. He was probably 11. And my Rottweiler's a puppy, and they were about the same. They had the same level of activity for the most part. But now at 16, like he's a lot less active. Man, I got to work on my English. Got to work on it, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm going out amongst 42 people watching me right now. I got to be on my point. So Cornelius said, I was attempting to say our Malinois was also mixed with Shepherd. Was 75 pounds, well-behaved, yet energetic, but shed more fur than the Akitas I grew up with. Okay, there you go. I got it out. All right, and then Doug says, that's why I want a Dutch versus a Malinois. Both have high drives, but Dutch can chill out. And the last comment, Giovanni Lewis says, because of movies and popularity, there are a lot of Belgians in the pound. Wow. That's something I probably should look at, because that's probably very true, because I can only imagine that, you know, a lot of people get excited about dog breeds, and I can really believe that, you know, these Belgian Malinois is not a toy breed. It's not a breed to play with. A lot of folks can't handle them. A lot of them would probably end up in the pound. This is a sad statement. It's a sad statement to make about people, that we want things without preparing ourselves to have them. But that's what we do, especially here in America, right? We're a capitalist society. That's what we do. Josu Perez, thank you, brother. Josu, I don't want to, is it Josu or Jose? I don't know. I don't want to talk about that right now in terms of the new home situation, because that's not kind of what this program's about. So I want to just keep it basically on the Belgian Malinois and the German Shepherd. All right, guys, we're coming up on we're at 43 minutes. So, you know, I like to make these shows about 45 minutes to an hour. So we're pretty good. I think we're going to wrap it up here. I want to thank you guys all, everybody. We got 45 likes. That was great. We had 100 yesterday. So if you got any more likes out there that we can get, please hit it up. Hit the like button. Let's make this thing as popular as possible. Also, tomorrow I'm going to be doing the show. I have a guest tomorrow, Fabian Chichester of the world-famous Remy line. So if you are an American Bully, a pit bull person, Amstaff person, for sure, check out tomorrow's show. And again, it should be at 2 o'clock. I'm trying to lock this in every day at 2 o'clock if I can. And I'm going to do that until I start. I didn't schedule any shoots this week, so I'm trying to do a live every day this week. But all right, guys, thank you so much again. I want you guys to have a wonderful day. If nothing else, get out my face and go walk your dog. All right, man. Peace.